Introduction. In target tracking, the primary algorithm for estimating the target state has been the Kalman filter, Blackman, 1986, and Blackman and Popoli, 1999. This workhorse algorithm and its nonlinear implementation, the extended Kalman filter, EKF, provide both an estimate of the target kinematic state, for example position and velocity, and an estimate of the error covariance associated with the target state, Brown, 1983. The linear Kalman filter is given as, where Xi is the track estimate, His the output coupling matrix that maps the track space to the measurement space, This the state coupling matrix that models the target motion, This the measurement from the sensor, P is the error covariance, Ki is the Kalman gain that weights the residual or innovation, Re is the measurement error covariance, and Ki is the process noise. The subscript Ki is the scan, K vertical bar k indicates the update from the new measurement, and K plus 1 vertical bar k denotes prediction. The basic premise of the Kalman filter is that the measurements are Gaussian random variables and the target motion's error or process noise is also Gaussian. For this reason, the Mahalanobis distance, Blackman, 1986, and Mahalanobis, 1936 has been used as a measure to determine how close a measurement is to a given track. The inner product measure of, 2, weights the residual in measurement space by the error covariance. Thus, a large covariance error reduces the effect of large differences. This chi-squared random variable has provided the primary scoring algorithm for the data association step in the tracking problem as seen in the Bowman model, Steinberg, Bowman, and White, 1999, in Figure 1. Target tracking functional flow. While the Kalman filter has its strengths, the Gaussian assumption is not always accurate. As seen in, a simplified model of a passive acoustic measurement is not well approximated by a Gaussian model. Near-field measurements of such a sensor have greater errors as shown in. With terrain and mapping information, target limitations and sensor blockage cannot be mapped without changing the underlying Gaussian assumption of the Kalman filter as done in, Yang and Lask, 2009. A. Measurement distributions, one with uniform distribution and one with Gaussian. B. Measurement distributions, with Gaussian distribution used to approximate a uniform distribution. A number of techniques have been derived to handle these issues. Some of the basic techniques include the use of Gaussian sums, Alsbach, 1970, and Alsbach and Sorensen, 1972, to approximate the non-Gaussian sensor measurements. The so-called unscented Kalman filer, UKF, Haken, 2002, and the particle filter, Orulam Palam et al., 2002, use samples of the probability density functions to combine the random variables of the track and measurement. N. Stubberud, 2003, and Stubberud, 2000, a sequential estimator that can incorporate constraints on the target state without a Gaussian assumption was developed. The single Mahalanobis distance of, 2, is not valid for the Gaussian sum and completely invalid for the other techniques. Near-field measurement error. Uncertainty error ellipses are affected by sensor blockage. A. Gaussian ellipses and blockage indicated, B. Resulting alteration of ellipse. Also, target tracking has grown beyond simple kinematic tracking. The use of classification information has also been incorporated into target track states. Usually, a Bayesian taxonomy, Pearl, 1988, or a Dempster-Shafer algorithm, Dempster, 1967, and Shafer, 1976, has been employed to provide the scoring for the classification association of the measurement to the target state. The kinematic score is then combined with the classification score using a technique defined by the implementer. Besides the improvement in the tracking algorithms, data fusion has grown well beyond the target tracking application. As defined in Steinberg, Bowman, and White, 1999, fusion now covers a number of interpretations of information from a wide variety of sources. Applications are more varied than the military surveillance and targeting that founded the research. However, as discussed in Stubberud, Shea, and Klamer, 2003, and Yunus et al., 2004, the association step is still important. Techniques that do not rely on a Gaussian random variable are necessary. In this lecture, an association technique that maps data into image representation is presented. The images are compared using a phase-only filter, POF, technique to provide a correlation score. The data can be from any source. Each source may contain an uncertainty measure or not. A single association score results. The development of this effort begins with a previously developed fuzzy logic kinematic association scoring technique that did not rely on the Gaussian assumption. This approach provides the foundation for incorporation of uncertainty into the image representation. The fuzzy approach discussion is followed by the original image correlation technique without uncertainty. The uncertainty incorporation is then developed. An example of tracking with kinematics and classification is provided.